Welcome back. Really, since the death this past weekend of actor Philip Seymour Hoffman, many people have gotten a reality check about the realities of heroin. And what we thought we'd do right now is we've heard perspectives throughout the week from family members on this, as well as also some people on the treatment first lines. But what we wanted to do was hear from the first responders. And that's the perspective we're gonna be getting because this epidemic is in full swing, and it was in full swing before Sunday's tragic event. And for more on that perspective, we turn to two veterans of law enforcement, Louis Falco III, he is the sheriff of Rockland County, New York, and Joseph Becerra. He is an investigator with the New York State Police in the Bureau of Criminal Investigation. Gentlemen, thank you very much for a few minutes. And for many people, Sunday may have been a wake-up call, but as I've seen in the conversations I've talked to people, families in a large part, they're saying that their tragedies, the Hoffman one, they're playing out all over the place, and this has been an epidemic, albeit for many people a quiet one that's played out and exploded in the last few years. From a ground level, have you seen that the same, that this 2 years ago, 5 years ago, we'd be having a different conversation about what we're seeing today?
Yes, I think that there's been a real swell with the use of heroin, and it, I think it relates back to, and we started to see a swing probably in 2009 or 10 with the use of prescription drugs by young adults between the ages of 16 and 26. And when they could no longer afford to keep up with that habit of prescription drugs, which were anywhere between $30 and $90 a pill, they reverted down to a $5 and $10 bag of heroin, which has caused what we have today and the increase in the deaths and the overdoses that confront us, not only in Rockland and Westchester, but the state and across the nation, I believe.
And this must be borne out in what you're seeing now with investigations. We're seeing large-scale busts that are attached to this. And, I mean, I remember dealing with the Attorney General's office the last few years. Their focus was on prescription drugs. And now I'm hearing from law enforcement all over the place. They're trying to play catch-up here with heroin, which we thought kind of the darkest days were in the 80s or 90s. And all of a sudden it's back with a vengeance in 2014.
Just to give you a brief statistic of how much it's increased over the last couple of years, in 2012, New York State Police, along with other local law enforcement agencies, seized over 40 pounds of heroin and made a little over 800 arrests. Last year, that number went up to 2,200 pounds of heroin seized and over 1,800 arrests. So just in a period of 1 year, that dramatic increase in seizures and arrests just goes to show you what we're facing at this time.
And I'll show my ignorance. Has heroin always been this cheap an alternative? I've heard the distribution channels have changed, that it's now coming up from Mexico instead of maybe from other points. And as a result here, you're having a pure drug that's more affordable that's now flooding the streets. Is that an oversimplification, or is it more right than wrong?
I think it's right on the money. The bottom line is, not only is it cheaper, it's pure, as you said, but now what they're doing is they're not cutting it as much, and when they're cutting it, they're using this new fentanyl, which is having an adverse reaction, which is, in a lot of cases, is expediting and causing those deaths.